The Mount Cameroon National Park, created in 2009 to conserve its unique landscape, animal and plant species, continuously suffer from pressure exerted by adjacent communities.
The great ape of the Mount Cameroon National Park and other species are increasingly becoming endangered. And because they're increasingly becoming endangered, many organizations have been taking different strategies to conserve these species. But no organization, or very few organizations, have been intentional about engaging children.
Considering that most efforts employed to dissuade adjacent communities from pressuring the park are not yielding the much desired fruits, conservationists are now using one last joker, which they think will bear sustainable yields.
Children hold the key to the future sustainability of the planet and the future conservation of these species, because they will be the one to grow up and be leaders that would decide the future of these species.
In this session at the Government High School Bukoba, the voice of the nature NGO drills the kids on the various species found at the park and the various ways they get to conserve them, even as young adults.
Most of these children have actually been cut off from nature and are buried in their phones, buried in their laptops, and they are not so much connected to nature as we were when we grew up as little children and we grew up in the forest environment. You saw how most of them here could testify that I've never been to the Mount Cameroon National Park, which is just a few kilometers away from where they live. So we said, no, it's good for us to embark on an aggressive effort to boost their appetite towards conserving these species and actively engaging them in taking up actions that can help the conservation of these species, both now and in the future.
Using sketches and literature, the conservationists gave the kids practical illustrations on how important these species are in balancing the ecosystem and breeding good life for all.
And we hope that at the end of this program, which started in the month of November and will run till July 2022, these children will have their appetite boosted in the conservation of these species. The children will be reconnected to nature. They will equally be able to gather pro-conservation traditional knowledge around the Mount Cameroon area for posterity. And all what we are going to produce at the end of this program, be it in the form of documentaries, environmental and conservation songs, magazines, will all culminate in enhancing other conservation efforts in the Mount Cameroon area.
The kids grew seriously inspired in taking up new responsibility in conserving the environment. They plan to begin by sensitizing their homes and their communities.
I'm very happy to have Vonat today in our school, and we've learned a lot of things. Vonat has sensitized us on so many things about nature. I'm going to take this back home. I've learned that it's good to sensitize our parents, our friends, and all those who go into the bush to hunt these endangered species. We are going to sensitize them and advise them that they should avoid hunting them and avoid putting traps that can easily wound them so that they don't go out of extinct.
Yeah, I'm going to educate my parents for burning of bushes, not be advisable, and for hunting and traps, it's not also be good to be using all those stuff.
First of all, I'll take it back home. I'll go and try to educate my younger ones and my mother, everybody. Because like in our village, when you hear that you are going to the forest to hunt, instead they'll be proud of you that you are hunting. Meanwhile, I did not know that it was a bad habit or something that is going to kill us, because they said it helped us to sustain the ecosystem.
At a time when kids' attentions are punctuated with a myriad of distractions, taking them down to their roots could be a sustainable way of conserving nature, hence the Mount Cameroon National Park.